The original NAP procedure was described for monocular elevation deficiency. It consisted of full tendon transposition of both horizontal recti to the corners of the superior rectus insertion. The basis for this transposition is that the further away the muscles are from the horizontal plane, the greater their vertical action. Today, a standard NAP is performed with a full tendon transfer, but the tendons are sutured at the tendon's original distances from the limbus, keeping the spiral of Tylor intact in order to prevent eye rotation created by the original NAP procedure. Kamlesh and Dadeya described a modified NAP that has been performed in monocular elevation deficiency associated with a horizontal deviation, wherein the horizontal recti are split and their superior halves are sutured to the superior rectus, while the inferior halves are used to correct the horizontal deviation. In the augmented NAP described by Sneer, for large degrees of hypotropia, a greater effect is obtained by combining a full trunnion transfer with a posterior fixation or Foster suture. 25% of the bellies of each of the horizontal recti are sutured to the sclera adjacent to the superior rectus and about 8 mm posterior to its insertion. The inverse NAP procedure is used for the treatment of double depressor palsy and congenital or acquired inferior rectus deficiency. The horizontal recti are transposed close to the inferior rectus insertion. If you like this video, you may show your appreciation by making a small contribution to help support the channel. Here below the video window, click on Super Thanks. Choose the amount you would like to contribute. And then click Buy and Send to complete the transaction. Thank you.